A stadium known by many names these days, Sun Life Stadium is the home for this AFC matchup between the Patriots and the Dolphins. You know, when you get a matchup at running back, like the one we have here today, you can just look down on the field from the booth, and you can see that breakaway speed and power with your own eyes, and there is a difference out there.
Yeah, I think I was always heard from Bill Walsh. I read it in his book. Trust your eyes. So you're right. We look.
The ball comes out, picking up the fumble, and now he's on the move, bringing the play to an end.
One of the reasons why you put all those fast guys on your kicking team, so when that football comes loose like it did then, your guys can react and recover the fumble.
Wide receivers are bunched up.
First and 10. Charles is handed the football, searching for space to the right. Able to make the tackle about 2 yards shy of the first.
That was a nice run that time by the offense, picking up those yards. And anytime you gain more than 3 yards on a running play in the National Football League, it is deemed successful.
Lindley will take it right from the center. Jamal Charles then picks up the first. Imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
We talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one. And right now, the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
Gain of 2.
They keep fighting for every inch, every yard, as they move closer and closer to the end zone.
Well, this offense, they fit perfectly with the head coach. He's a tough guy. He's a grinder. And this offense, what a job here right now. They are grinding this football, like you said.
He's in for the touchdown.
This will make you feel good early in the game. You're down near the goal line, and you just line up, and you run the football right at the defense and get a touchdown.
The Patriots prepared to return the kick.
Send it to the 20-yard line.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Out of the eye, they give it to the tailback.
Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football. Try to wear the defense down.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. They're setting up screens.
The defense got away with one that time. It wasn't a good play on their part. It was just bad timing by the quarterback and receiver.
Offense lines up here. Third down and 7. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself 3 more opportunities.
First down here after the completion. They feed the running back. He's into the open. And now they'll try over again on second down. little screen. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
I think the best thing to say about that play, it's just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Brady's going to take it from the gun, looking to the right side and throwing. Tackled right around midfield.
Nice job by the quarterback finding the open guy short. They get the completion. They still do not get the first down, though.
The Dolphins defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Second and seven. Incomplete. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Third and seven. Play action. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Pass is made, and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out. Punters all set here. On the stop. The Dolphins come to the line and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. First and 10, going across the middle. Floyd's there with the sure hands to pull in the rocket pass.
Well, that's a good route that time by the wide receiver. They call that a post route, and they call it a post route because he is running towards the goal post. Nice throw and catch.
And Wallace, a receiver in the slot. Lindley's back at it now, dropping back once again. Mike Wallace makes the catch. Plenty of zip on that throw.
I love seeing the post route against defenses that are up there being aggressive, trying to stop the run. You go down the field, how about that? Stick that foot into the ground, make that break at 10 yards, and run right down the middle of the field on that post route.
First and 10. Going off tackle here.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Lindley will take it right from the center. Second and 14 to the right. And they bring it down at the 36-yard line.
The off-tackle run, it's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
Charles is in the slot, not in the backfield for this play. That catch gives them a first down. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
That's a nice route on the outside. Nice throw by the quarterback. Puts him in good position to keep moving and get a first down.
Floyd's in the slot. First and 10, Jamal Charles carries the football.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Second down coming up. They feed it to him again. Left side.
Good job that time by the offense. Powell run gets him a few yards.
The Dolphins are at the line, facing third down, which was not an issue for them last week as they converted a number of times in crucial situations.
Terrible throw by the quarterback, terrible route by the wide receiver. Oh, wow, what a shock. The football was incomplete. That's just some bad play calling there at the end, Jim. It was a beautiful drive down the field by the offense, but they should have paid it off for 7 points. Bad calls. The offense can't overcome it, but the kicker comes through and at least gets some 3 points.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Stacked up on this play.
First and 10. Quarterback flips it to the running back.
When you see long runs like that by a running back, a lot of things have to happen. Of course, he has good vision and he has talent. But how about those blocks down the field, those blocks in the secondary? That's what creates long runs.
One more snap and another quarter is in the books.
Brady is in the shotgun. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. And we'll return after this message and a word from your local station. Pass play wasn't good for much. So now it's second down and 9. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Going to lose yards here.
The quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
The defense comes out in the nickel. Now it's a 3rd and 13. Tom Brady unleashes the long pass.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than 7, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Let's see how they back up the big play here.
The give.
They're going to run it right.
Really important they find a way to score in this drive here. So close to the goal line, they got to get back in this game. And if they find a way to score, even though they'll still be behind, it'll give them a lot of confidence.
Offense lines up here. Another carry here. Touchdown. That'll close the gap.
When you're behind in a football game, drive down and score. They did that. Now the next time when they get back out there, they got to do it again. Show some patience and drive it down the field.
Steven Gostkowski's readying his team for the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Setting up in the pistol on this play.
A tackle behind the line.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second down now.
Lindley's back in shotgun formation. Brown's got the cool hands on a pass that had a lot of heat.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game, tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
And they'll give it to Jamal Charles. They get to him just in time, 1 yard shy of the first down.
An off-tackle run. It's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Kind of refreshing to watch, isn't it, to see a team that has faith, the toughness, and the patience to just keep running the football, grinding out these first downs, resting their defense, and tiring out the opponent's defense.
Jamal Charles is in the backfield, and they go back to the ground.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the secondary and make a big play?
Second down after going to the ground game the first play. He gets it again on this drive. They've got him down there.
Hey, this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time, they stopped that run just for a short gain.
James split out wide on the left. Third and two. Makes the reception. Tackle down at the 22.
Good job by the receiver that time. Get that extra couple yards. Gets a first down. They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
Jamal Charles is in the backfield. First and 10. They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short gain.
2 minute warning.
This will be second down. With a screen set up here. They bring him to the turf.
Good job by the play caller that time. Calling for the short pass. Even though it comes up short of the first down, it opens up many things that you can do on third. You can run a reverse, draw plays, screen plays, or if you want, you can still throw it down the field.
Floyd's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Lindley's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Michael Floyd pulls it in.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets the completion. And there's some tight spots. Not a lot of room. So you got to really drive the football in there.
Mounting a serious drive. First and goal from the eye. They give it to the deep back.
When you have a lead and your offense is playing like this, what's it do? Gives your defense a great rest. They're loving this drive as they sit on the sideline.
This long drive continues. Quarterback, quick toss to the outside. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage. And you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
What a drive this has been. Third and goal from the 10. Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
Anytime, Jim, it's third and goal, you've got to decide, what are we going to do? Well, this time the offense, nice design. They throw the football, and the quarterback puts it right on the money for the touchdown pass.
Out across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
down here.
Screen play is on. Got a flag down here, and that's a gain of maybe five. Player showing no restraint, coming in on the quarterback, and that late hit will cost his team 15.
A lot of times these late hits are called, and I feel for the defensive player. Not in this case. That was an easy call, a blatant late hit. It's worthy of 15 yards.
Come to the line, and it's first down.
Snap back to Brady from the gun. Gets a hand on that one to knock it away.
He did everything right, didn't he, the cornerback that time? He was physical. He stayed on the wide receiver. He was reading the quarterback, so it was easy for him to knock the throw down.
The defense comes out of the nickel.
Second down and 10. Wide open for the catch. You talk about controlling the flow of the game. Another first down, and the drive keeps on going.
Yeah, why not? The defense, they're just sitting over there. They're taking the hits and not even fighting back. It's a terrible job by the defense.
Was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. The defense gets a sack.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see. They don't have to blitz, and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Tom Brady under center. Play action fake. Looking to throw. Brady connects with Gronkowski. The Patriots with no timeouts left.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag. Run to the flag of the end zone. Or a seven route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the wide receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
And the kick is good for three.
When an offense drives the ball, they always want to get something out of it, get some points. This time, the field goal kicker gets it done. He gives them three.
For a touchback. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. This is a screen play all the way. Gain of 17. So that's going to do it for the first half here. Dolphins are up in this one.
We're back here now in this one where the Dolphins are leading by 7.
Let's check in on the sidelines. Danielle Bellini is there.
Guys, I caught up with Coach Philbin during halftime. His team has the lead, and he told me he's proud of the way his guys have battled it out there. He said it hasn't been pretty the whole time, but his players have been resilient, and that's a major factor in the score. Hopefully his players will keep it up here in the second half, guys. Back to you.
Thanks, Danielle, and now we'll go to the field. Lined up in the slot. And now here's the first snap of the second half.
So many things you could do on first down. And what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
And here we have second down.
Throws to the right. Under pressure and incomplete.
This is third down
from the gun. Kyle Arrington has the interception. He's brought down.
Jim, this defense is just attacking today. They got the offense backed up. They go after them. They're aggressive. And what does it do for them? It gets them an interception inside the opponent's 20-yard line.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. He gets the toss. They break through. Tackle him behind the line.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down following the run. The handoff, running behind the tackle, gains 5.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
It's third down coming up. Brady standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains.
They've got a first down now after that catch.
They'll run it. Here's the handoff.
Hard to score a touchdown sometimes when you get in the red zone in the NFL. Why? Because the defense doesn't have to worry about passes down the field. The offense runs it. They are ready to get it done, and they do, and stop the offense for a short gain.
Second down.
Staying on the ground. Goes to the left. Patriots in the end zone.
There's no doubt about it. When you score like that to tie up the game, it shifts momentum. And it's all up now to the offense of the other team to get back out there and get the momentum back on their side.
Add the extra point. The kick is good.
The Dolphins are back deep waiting for the kick.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. On first down, takes the snap from the shotgun. The Dolphins now move the chains.
Good job by the quarterback that time. He doesn't panic. He reads that it's a zone, and you have to wait for the receivers to get in between the defenders. Nice throw and catch.
Charles is lined up as the single back. He's brought to a halt.
Well, this, you know, you're just getting dominated physically when the offense just runs the football right up the middle. The middle linebacker and the defensive tackles just have to be better.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Staying with the running game on first down.
What a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
That's second down coming up.
Ball is snapped and the quarterback tosses it to the outside. A game breaker. Touchdown.
Anytime you see a running back get in the secondary, from there he can make it happen. But to get in the secondary, you got to have good blocking up front. Nice job by the offensive line.
Everyone's lined up for this kickoff.
just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. Down here. Tossing it to the running back. Breaks free. He steps out.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all in one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
Here they come, back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Leading on that running attack again here on first down.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
The defense comes out of the dime. Second and seven. Challenging the defenders to the right side. He's going to be tackled right around the 49.
Well, that's a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and receiver. Puts them in good position where they have a chance to pick up this third down.
Offense needs 2 yards here on third down after that pass play. The quarterback will hand it off. This offense can't be stopped on third down no matter the distance.
You know, when the linebackers, when they see that the offensive formation is shifted to one side, well, as a linebacker, you got to play to that strong side and try to get up there and stop the run.
Lining up here after picking up more than 30 on the previous play.
Oh, bad decision on time by the quarterback. He tries to force the football into the end zone and it almost gets picked off by the defense.
Tom Brady under center. Second down and 10.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. Down inside, when you're inside that 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Handoff out of the I formation. It's a touchdown.
I would bet first and goal that the offense, about 90% of the time, is going to run the football. And what do they do here? They run it and they get it done. That is power football at its best.
Patriots now getting ready to kick it away. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. First down, offense readying for the snap. To the right side. Gets past the first wave.
Well, the offense is down here in the red zone or the green zone if you like to think of money. And it's a tie game. A lot of things you could do. They love to throw it in the end zone, but maybe they'll cross them up with a run. We'll find out.
offense lines up again after that jolting 60-yard-plus play. And that's good for only a yard or two.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to get a lot of yards. And that time, they just got a short game.
Offense lines up here. The final quarter begins with this snap. That's a touchdown.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts them ahead. And it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
An extra point is good. Dolphins set to kick it. They'll take it at the 20. Nickel formation here for the defense. First and 10. Into the open flat. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
That reception gave them the first down. Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down coming up.
Hard to throw over some of these linebackers in the NFL now. They got such good size. You try to throw over them, here's what happens. These big guys will knock it down.
Shane Vereen lined up in the backfield. Third and 15, and looking to the right side and throwing.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
They ought to award him four if he makes this. No good. An empty trip for the offense. So they opt to go for the long field goal try early in this game. And with the missed kick, they give their opponents some great starting field position.
Yeah, I thought it was a big risk trying this long field goal here early in the game. And it could backfire on them. We'll see if the defense can bail them out.
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get in that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
Second and three after that last carry. They hand it off to the running back, and that's a gain of 10.
Well, the defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
First down here after the run. And they'll run the football with Charles. And they bring him down at the 33-yard line.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight film, but still a good solid run up in there for a couple yards.
Charles is in the backfield. Single back set. Second down and 7. Flip to the outside. Brought down just 2 yards shy of the first down marker.
put it up in the full house formation.
Third and two. Jamal Charles then picks up about three.
Even though the defense knows of how they're going to run the football, it's third and short. If you run hard, all you need is a little bit of a lane. We see it there, able to get the first down.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Toss to the outside.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
We're late in the game, and the offense is in no hurry. They go to the right side. That's a gain of eight.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
The defense needs a big stop here in order to give the offense a chance as we're running low on time in this one. Here on third and five. Trying to work that left side. There's the offense picking up another first down on third down.
When you play man-to-man against this receiver, you're going to have a tough time. Quarterback's a good thrower. Really hard for a defensive back to stay with him.
First down here after the completion.
High formation and a running play.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
And now we reach the two-minute warning. Second down here. Jamal Charles carries the football. Runs it in for the touchdown.
Well, you got a lead. Now you're able to go out there and drive down the field and score a touchdown. This changes how the other team is going to manage the game from here on out.
The Patriots prepare to return the kick. It's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. Down as they head to the line.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. And he's almost intercepted.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver, running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
Tom Brady under center on second and 10. Set up screen. Caught. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
The Patriots go with two tight ends on this play.
Third and 16.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. And that's going to be a three and out.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
They're in punting formation.
Antonio Brown will return this punt. Gain of 16. Lindley will take it right from the center. First and 10. And they'll give it to Jamal Charles.
Well, even though they have a lead here, it's late in the fourth quarter, you still got to be unpredictable. Keep the defense on edge. As I always say,
make the defense react and not attack. So make them guess what plays you're going to run.
After running it, it's second down. Takes a knee. This game's come to an end.